Have you ever wondered what is happening when ice cream starts as a solid scoop on top of a cone, but then melts into a liquid mess? What about the steam you see above a boiling pot? As the ice cream melts and drips down your hand, you are actually observing a phase change of matter. A phase change occurs when matter physically changes from one state, a solid, liquid, or gas, to another. This change occurs due to the matter absorbing or losing energy. All matter is made up of molecules, which are always moving. This movement of energy is known as kinetic energy. Differences in this kinetic energy help us understand why matter can exist in the different states of solid, liquid, and gas. Let's break that down a bit more. Scientists state that molecules are attracted to each other and tend to stick together. Their bonds will break only if there is enough kinetic change to move them. When the bonds break, the matter changes state. This measure of kinetic energy in matter is known as temperature. The greater a matter's internal energy, the higher the temperature of that material. However, when the temperature, or energy, decreases, the molecules settle down into a more rigid structure. Transfer of heat is needed for matter to change state. Let's look at some examples. Let's first look at the changes between liquids and solids. What do you think happens when you freeze a liquid? When you pour juice into a mold, it is a liquid. Once you place it in a cold freezer, heat transfers between the warm mold and the cold air inside the freezer. The heat from the mold and juice transfers until no energy is available in the juice for the molecules to slide past one another, so they stay in place as a solid, frozen treat. Once the frozen treat is taken out of the freezer, it will slowly turn back into a liquid as it melts. Since the temperature is much warmer outside the freezer than inside, the solid treat absorbs the surrounding heat, which gives more kinetic energy to the molecules so they are free to move around again. The frozen treat changes phases and becomes a liquid. Next, let's look at the changes between liquids and gases. If you fill a pot with cold water and place it on a hot stovetop, the water heats up. Heat energy travels from the stovetop to the pot, and the water absorbs the energy from the pot. Once the water is hot enough, it will start to boil, forming bubbles of water vapor in the pot of water. These bubbles are created as particles of liquid water gain enough kinetic energy to move freely and change to gas. The bubbles rise through the water and leave the pot as steam. The process in which a liquid boils and changes to a gas is called vaporization. Have you ever noticed that if you take a shower, the bathroom mirror fogs up? This happens because some of the hot water from the shower evaporates. When the hot water touches the mirror, which is cooler, it loses kinetic energy. These water droplets now come together and form liquid droplets on the mirror. This process is called condensation. The last phase change we will discuss today is the change between solids and gases. Generally, solids that change to gas will pass through the liquid state first, but sometimes solids skip a state and change directly to gas. The opposite can also happen, where gases change directly into solids. When a solid changes directly into a gas, it is called sublimation. Let's watch this process happen with this dry ice. Dry ice is the solid, frozen form of the gas carbon dioxide. Dry ice is very dangerous to touch as it is extremely cold and can cause frostbite. When dry ice is exposed to anything over negative 109 degrees Fahrenheit, it will melt, causing it to turn directly into carbon dioxide gas, which you can see here. The opposite process is called deposition, when matter changes from a gas to a solid without going through the liquid state first. One example of deposition is frost. When warm, moist air touches very cold surfaces, ice crystals are deposited on them. Deposition can also happen in the atmosphere, where ice crystals form on tiny dust particles. These ice crystals form clouds, most often cirrus clouds, which appear as thin, wispy white streaks in the sky. Phase changes of matter happen around us every day. Sometimes they are beautiful, like this field decorated with a phenomenon known as hoarfrost. And sometimes they are delicious, like the fragrant steam rising above a pot of boiling spaghetti sauce. The next time you hurriedly eat a rapidly melting ice cream cone, remember, you are observing one of the amazing processes of the natural world.